Most arrival around time from the instant our alarm go up to attend an afternoon appointment to the moment we call bedtime. Tick tack. But have you ever wondered why time go forward or backward? Well, I'm Yasmin Malak, Allah Abkar, and I'm going to explain this. Let's start this puzzle. Why the first one looks totally normal, but the second one looks strange. The second one is the first one, the universe. But something about it seems off. This never happened. I met in one day with a glass of water left out, will never morph into a cube of ice.
Sounds simple, but why exactly is it impossible universe?
There is a deep mystery lurking behind our seemingly simple ice melted puzzle. At the level of microscopic particle, nature doesn't have preference the wind in from one direction versus the wind in a reverse. The atomic world have two histories. The basic law of physics doesn't say anything about direction of time.
Why? Basic law of physics relates what's going out, what's happened previously, and what will happen.
However, there is only one rule that have time go from one direction only, the second law of thermodynamics. It says that over time, everything moves from an ordered state to disordered state. For example, when you mix milk and coffee, to have and mix coffee milk, which leads us to entropy.
What is entropy?
Entropy is moving from an ordered state to disordered state. Once a system gets a fully disordered state equilibrium, there is no more direction of increasing entropy to define the order of time. So the fact we experience the flow of time right now means we're not in equilibrium. Going down this road leads us to the start of our universe. At some point in the far past, the universe started with ever lower entropy and disorder has been increasing ever since. That low configuration was the beginning. Things want to be gravitationally comes together into concentrated configuration like stars or galaxies or even black hole from a very delicately balanced low entropy state which is not equilibrium to define the arrow of time. Well, with a high entropy, equilibrium will look like empty space. Indeed, the universe is expanding and eventually all the stars will burn out and will be left with nothing but emptiness in every direction. At that point, time either will disappear and nothing like life will be possible. We don't know why the universe started in such an ordered state, but we should be glad it did. It gives us the non-equilibrium starting point that is necessary for the flow of time as we know it to exist. Everything that followed from the formation of stars and galaxies to the origin of life has been a story of increasing entropy. Finally, as Vaquero said, understanding how evolution of time comes about in this way opens up a whole new view in the fundamental nature of time itself, and it might even help us to better understand the bigger idea such as traveling back in time.